We observed thousands and thousands of changes at the molecular and genetic level when Scott Kelly was in space. We observed changes in small molecules in the bloodstream, changes in how genes go up and go down, changes in how DNA was packaged, and telomeres got longer, the microbiome in the gut changed, we saw stresses in the body, changes in his vision, and also we've been looking intensely at immune cells, which are notoriously adaptive, and so we know that these cells are expected to change.
This is the first time ever that we've studied a twin in spaceflight and one on the ground. So we have the same genetic background in both individuals and are now looking at how the environment changes things, in this case, spaceflight. The gene expression in Scott's white blood cells changed in flight. 7% of the gene expression persisted 6 months after his flight. So genes are not on or off, they're throttled like your automobile engine. 7% of them were throttled in a different position even 6 months after flight.
You know, 7% of genes sounds like a lot, but it's important to remember that it's the genes just changing their expression, going up and down. So Scott and Mark Kelly are still identical twins. They may have had changes in their chromosomes, so how DNA is packaged, but at the end of the day, they're still gonna look like each other. They're definitely still twins. The really big question is, what about 3 years? Should we expect to see, you know, basically 3 times the number of changes, 10 times the number of changes? Really, we don't know at this point because this is the first study of its kind. This sets the bedrock of knowledge for all the future astronaut studies. The vision of the future would be, you look at the entire genetic code, all the molecular structures and changes in an individual, and then customize what he or she will need for long-term missions. So this could be physical changes to how they do exercise, and also even just how they take vitamins and how they even do manage their microbiome. Really, every molecule is fair game for making sure it's customized for each astronaut.
This research helps us in exploration by understanding how the human body and mind responds to spaceflight. The space station is our stepping stone to further journeys to the moon and to Mars.